What's up, folks? Welcome to the channel, Rockin' the Country. I'm Don. We've been at this for quite a while. Some of you folks have been around for a long time. Some names I haven't seen in a long time either, but I suspect you'll probably check it out once in a while. And I guess it's like 4.5 years in now, and it's a blast. I've learned a ton, and it's just a beautiful community that, you know, we've got, you know. The folks, just so many of you are just good folks, and I love that part. It's a hard world in which to live, and when you got good folks around, even if it's just in comments once in a while, it's fantastic. So, speaking of fantastic, Carolina's Beauty, shout out to you. She made a special donation. I reacted to Blake Shelton's song, The Baby, that she'd also mentioned as an option for me to react to. I think she'd given me three. And I was like, I'm going to do at least two of them. And this is the second one. The Baby got me good. I have to tell you, you probably saw, if you watched that reaction, you'd have seen it. It got to me. Kenny Rogers, the King of Oak Street. That's the one. And so Carolina's Beauty, thank you again for your PayPal donation. It's just, whenever I see that little notice on my phone, I'm like, oh my gosh, somebody really loves this. So, all right, let me take this off. Yeah, I don't know. I don't think I know this song, The King of Oak Street. So let's see.
Like a leaf caught in the wind, he drifted wild, with no purpose or direction to his life.
Such a soothing voice.
He tried to get himself together, pacify his mind and forget about the things he'd left behind.
All right, nice start.
A crying woman he left standing at his door. With a 2-month-old baby in her arms, his little black book he left torn up on the floor.
Messed up.
God only knows he never meant to do her wrong.
It's gotta suck.
A careless weekend on the other side of town has torn the king of Oak Street's castle down, and all week long he's tried phone her, but she won't let him explain. Now Sunday morning finds him walking in the rain.
This is way too, not real to me. I mean, I know people in this situation, and I know a lot of women who've been in this situation or who are in it, you know. I never had that problem straying, you know. It's hard enough, you know, to be locked into one woman and try doing all this stuff, but yeah, it'll tear a man down. And then even if it's just one mistake, she won't pick up the phone. Man, you know it's deep shit. All right, here we go.
He sits down in a phone booth and he prays that she'll forgive him and she'll believe he's changed his ways.
That'll take some time, homeboy.
With shaking hands, he deposits his last dime.
I'm gonna stop for a second, too. I mean, he banged someone else and he's got a 2-month-old. I mean, that's just so unfair to her. And if the girl on the other side of town knew that he'd had a wife and a 2-month-old, she's as bad as he is. You don't stab someone else in the back. All right, here we go.
And he still prayed that she won't hang up this time. Then the sweetest voice he's ever heard says hello.
Huh. Didn't see that coming.
Breakfast's almost ready, baby. Come on home.
Really?
I thought the whole thing over, and I think I understand that the King of Oak Street, just an ordinary man. I thought the whole thing over, and I think I understand that the King of Oak Street is just an ordinary.
That's a beautiful. In order to forgive someone, you have to have another idea in your head that you can turn to, other than they did me wrong or whatever it was that they did. And she found her one where I guess this guy was looked up to, was sort of like, you know, idolized in some way. And that's where we can get into trouble, where we've got our heroes and these people that we put up on pedestals. And you live long enough and you discover everybody's just, we all deal with the same thing. I mean, you've heard me say it on the channel, the great equalizer is we're going to die one day. And that's not to be macabre or morbid, even though it is literally a morbid topic. Death is, that's what that is. But we need ideas to hold on to that are good ideas to come back to the table with another person. And forgiveness is such a tough one in some ways. And in my life coaching, I'll put it, or just conversation with people, but certainly in life coaching, when you get involved in the nooks and crannies of people's lives and you see how difficult things are, you can't just come out and say, forgive the person. Because one, that may not even be the best thing to do or the right thing to do, because that person might just trample on you again and again and again. And how stupid are you? You know, and those aren't judgment calls that I make. Everybody has to live their own life. But people are, I have seen people, and it's a beautiful thing. I've seen mostly men step out, I think. And I've seen women forgive them. And it's hard and it's painful, because as human beings, you know, we're supposed to have one partner for life. That's kind of like our idea, you know, at least in the US and Canada and, you know, Western, we're like sand cranes. We go with the same partner through life. That's the ideal. That's how we conceptualize it. And then when somebody steps out, you know, and I know women who have stepped out too, and it's just very hard to fix that. It's hard to get that trust back. But people have done it and had happy marriages after that. And that's, you know, you're just a man. You're just a man, just like everybody else. That's what she saw, but not in a negative light, because Kenny sang that so poignantly, so sweetly, not with a tinge of anger at all. It was just the King of Oak Street And I like that oak, you know, it's supposed to be strong like an oak tree, but he's just a man. Got his frailties. And there was a sweetness there. And what a feeling to be forgiven actively by another person. Sometimes I think we spend too much time this idea of asking God for forgiveness when the person you need it from is your wife. And you won't have to ask your two-month-old for forgiveness, but really the right in front of you is what's there. Go after getting that forgiveness. Of course, this is good too, but if that's how you roll. But Carolina's Beauty, interesting request. Sometimes I think you guys like to see me react to songs just to see me squirm. I don't know, just to pontificate on life, because I love doing that. You know, that's something I love doing. So, but I normally don't rate them, but yeah, I think I'll rate that one. I'd never heard it. It was a beautiful song. Kenny's delivery was second to none. I mean, you just feel welcome when you hear him sing a song. You just feel welcome. You don't feel like anything's coming at you. You just feel like, wow, it's just a welcoming experience. So that, the song was nice. The lyrics, the storyline was fine. And I like, you know, it's just a pretty storyline. The number that popped into my head, I had two numbers that popped into my head. So I'm going to go with the higher of the two and come in with a 9.0. I had an 8.9 or a 9.0 pop into my head. So we're going with the 9.0. It really, you know, enwrapped me. Is that even the word? A word. So that's it. Carolina's Beauty, thank you again. And that's it, guys. Leave your comments. Have a great day. I'll see you on another video. Keep rocking the country.